iOS. iOS is Apple's mobile operating system. Sleek, stable, and completely in control. It only runs on iPhones and iPads, which means Apple gets to design the rules and the playground. Everything looks smooth, feels fast, and even older devices keep getting updates for years. People love how it syncs across devices. Your messages, photos, and notes just float between your phone, laptop, and watch like they're all part of one brain. But freedom? That's another story. Want to install an app from outside the App Store? Nope. Customize your icons or change the theme. Better read a 10-step guide. Share files without AirDrop? You'll need courage. iOS is beautiful, but it's also a little bossy. It's the OS that takes care of you. But only if you follow the house rules. No SD cards, no headphone jack, and don't even think about using the same charging cable as your friend, Android. Android is the world's most popular mobile OS, and probably the most chaotic. It's open source, made by Google, and used by dozens of phone brands, from Samsung to tiny no-name models, with 3 charging ports and 27 pre-installed apps. Android lets you do almost anything. Change your launcher, customize icons, install apps from sketchy websites, or even turn your phone into a mini spaceship. It's freedom. With consequences. Because not all Androids are equal. Some are blazing fast. Others lag when you open the camera. Updates? That depends on your phone, your brand, your region, and whether Mercury is in retrograde. Many phones come stuffed with bloatware you didn't ask for and can't delete. And some features vary wildly depending on who made your phone and what mood they were in that day. Still, Android is the OS of possibilities. If iOS is a private school, Android is a giant DIY festival. Messy, loud, but kind of amazing. Symbian. Before smartphones were smart, there was Symbian, the OG mobile operating system. It powered Nokia's back when they ruled the world, and it did everything. Calls, texts, music, photos, Bluetooth file sharing, even full-on apps. All packed into phones that could survive a drop from the second floor. Symbian was reliable, efficient, and honestly way ahead of its time. Some of us still remember playing Snake while the battery lasted an entire week, but when touchscreens took over, Symbian didn't keep up. The menus felt ancient, the icons didn't know what year it was, and updating the system meant plugging into a PC and praying. While Android and iOS were reinventing the smartphone, Symbian was still asking if you wanted to exit this menu. Still, it had charm. You could set any sound as a ringtone. You could explore system folders like a hacker. It wasn't perfect, but it felt like your phone really belonged to you. Windows Phone. Windows Phone wasn't just another mobile OS. It was Microsoft's bold attempt to reinvent the smartphone. And honestly, it was beautiful. The live tiles, the smooth animations, the clean, minimalist design. It felt futuristic, like using a phone from 10 years ahead. Everything was snappy, organized, and somehow satisfying. But then reality hit. The App Store was a desert. No Instagram filters. No proper YouTube app. No love from developers. People liked the interface, but couldn't live without their favorite apps. And once even Microsoft lost interest, things went downhill fast. One day you had a sleek phone. The next day, no support, no updates, and a quiet goodbye. Still, Windows Phone deserves a moment of silence. It tried to be different, and for a brief, shining moment, it was. BlackBerry OS. BlackBerry OS was built for business. Back when phones had actual keyboards and emails were the peak of mobile power, BlackBerry ruled every boardroom. It had encrypted messaging, serious security, and that satisfying click-click sound when you typed. If you saw someone with a BlackBerry, they probably had a meeting or felt important pretending they did. But while the world moved toward touchscreens, selfies, and swipe-based everything, BlackBerry stuck to buttons. It added apps, tried a touchscreen, even flirted with Android, but the spark never came back. Eventually, people wanted Instagram more than enterprise email. Still, BlackBerry OS had its moment. It was cool without trying to be cool. And if you ever typed a full paragraph without looking, you know the magic. Harmony OS. Harmony OS is Huawei's answer to Android. Or at least, that's what it wants you to believe. Officially, it's a brand new operating system. Unofficially, it walks like Android, talks like Android, and runs Android apps. Some say it's Android with a makeover, others say it's something more. Either way, it was born when Huawei got cut off from Google and had to build its own way forward. Fast. On the surface, Harmony OS looks slick. It works across phones, watches, tablets, even fridges. The whole idea is one system, many devices, perfect harmony. But the deeper you go, the more it starts to feel familiar, like you've seen this before, like you're still in Android's house, just wearing someone else's clothes. In the end, Harmony OS is less about tech and more about survival. And hey, if it works, who cares what's underneath? Kai OS. Kai OS is what happens when classic phones get a tiny taste of the internet. It runs on feature phones, yes, the ones with physical buttons, and somehow brings apps like WhatsApp, Google Maps, and YouTube to a T9 keyboard. It's lightweight, super affordable, and wildly popular in places where smartphones are still a luxury. You won't find fancy animations or a cinematic lock screen, but for millions of people, Kai OS is the first step into the online world, and it does the job. Fast boot, long battery life, and a menu that feels like 2005. With 4G. Sure, it's not made for multitasking, and yes, typing a message takes some thumb gymnastics. But it proves you don't need a $1,000 phone to watch a video or send a meme. Sometimes all you need is a signal and a bit of patience. Fire OS. Fire OS is Amazon's take on Android, modified, branded, and fully optimized for buying things. It powers Kindle Fire tablets, Fire TV devices, and other Amazon gear. On the surface, it looks like Android. It runs Android apps, mostly. But underneath, it's Amazon all the way down. With Alexa instead of Google Assistant, Amazon App Store instead of Play Store, and recommendations on every screen. The experience? Smooth enough. Affordable tablets, simple interface. Great for reading, streaming, and being gently nudged to buy more socks, or books, or 10 other things you didn't search for but are now recommended just for you. Fire OS works best if you live inside the Amazon ecosystem, but if you stray, try installing YouTube or Google Maps, you might find locked doors and missing features. It's like Android with one rule: shop responsibly, or don't. We'll remind you anyway. Tizen. Tizen is Samsung's in-house operating system, the one you've probably used without even knowing. It runs on smartwatches, TVs, fridges, and sometimes even ovens. It's fast, efficient, and doesn't crash when you're asking your fridge for the weather. But despite all that, it never really made it big on phones. Samsung tried. A few Tizen smartphones were released and then quietly disappeared. Turns out, people didn't want a phone without the Play Store, or with a browser that felt like it came from 2012. So while Tizen thrived on wristwear and appliances, it never got invited to the smartphone party. Still, it's out there. Quietly powering your smart TV menu, counting your steps, or updating your washing machine. Tizen didn't win the phone war, but it sort of won everything else. Ubuntu Touch, Sailfish, and the others. Not every mobile OS was trying to take over the world. Some just wanted to exist, like Ubuntu Touch, a mobile version of the popular Linux desktop system. It had gestures, sidebars, and the dream of one device for everything. Sounded cool, but almost no one built phones for it. So it became the OS of tech enthusiasts, tinkerers, and brave optimists. Then there's Sailfish OS, developed in Finland by ex-Nokia folks. It's sleek, privacy-focused, and kind of beautiful. But you've probably never seen it in real life. Most people haven't. A few other experiments popped up too. Firefox OS, Plasma Mobile, and even something called Asteroid OS. For smartwatches, these systems never got mainstream love, but they still matter, because every OS that almost worked taught us something. Mostly, making a mobile operating system is hard, really hard.